This is the internal structure of dicot or dorsiventral leaf. The thin transverse section of dicot leaf shows the following structure. One is upper epidermis, lower epidermis, mesophyll tissues, pollicyte parenchyma, spongy parenchyma, and vascular bundles. So first one, upper epidermis. Upper epidermis is made up of thin walled parenchymatous tissue, single layer, without intercellular spaces. The outer walls covered cuticle. Thick cuticle is present in the outer layer. Stomata are less in number. Next, lower epidermis. Lower epidermis also made up of parenchymata cells with intercellular space. Thin cuticle is present. It contains numerous stomata than the upper epidermis. Chloroplast are present only in god cells. This is a god cells. And the lower epidermis helps in gaseous exchange. Next, mesophyll tissue. Mesophyll tissue is present in between the upper epidermis and lower epidermis is called mesophyll. It is differentiated into pollicyte parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. So, pollicyte parenchyma, it is found just below the upper epidermis. The cells are elongated. More number of chloroplast is present without intracellular space. The main functions of pollicyte parenchyma take part in photosynthesis because more number of chloroplast is present in the pollicyte parenchyma. Next, spongy parenchyma. It is found below the pollicyte parenchyma tissue. Cells are almost spherical or oval in shape. It is irregularly arranged. Cells have intracellular spaces. It is helps in gaseous exchange. Next, vascular bundle. Vascular bundle, midrib is larger. Vascular bundles are conjoined, collateral and closed. You know that meaning of conjoined, collateral and closed. Each vascular bundle surrounded by the sheath is called bundle sheath. Each vascular bundle consists of xylem and phloem. Xylem lies towards the upper epidermis, phloem lies towards the lower epidermis. This is the internal structure of monocot leaf or isobilateral leaf. The thin transverse section of monocot leaf shows the following structure. Upper epidermis, lower epidermis, mesophyll tissue, vascular bundles. So first one, epidermis. Epidermis is present in both sides, upper epidermis, lower epidermis. In monocot leaf has the upper epidermis and lower epidermis. It is made up of parenchymata cells. Cuticle is present on both outer walls here and there, and stomata are present both upper and lower epidermis. Some cells of upper epidermis are large and thin walled. They are known as bulliform cells. What is it? Bulliform cells. Next, mesophyll tissue. Mesophyll tissue is present between the both upper epidermis and lower epidermis. It is not differentiated into pollicyte parenchyma and spongy parenchyma like dicot leaf. The cells are irregularly arranged with the intracellular space. These cells contain chloroplast. Next, vascular bundles. Large number of vascular bundles are present. Some of which are small and larger in size. These are larger in size. Some of the vascular bundles are smaller in size. Each vascular bundle is surrounded by a bundle sheath. It is made up of parenchymata tissue. Vascular bundles are conjoined, collateral and closed vascular bundle. Xylem lies towards the upper epidermis, phloem lies towards the lower epidermis. We have to completed internal structure of dicot and monocot leaf. Now we will see difference between the dicot and monocot leaf. So dicot leaf, monocot leaf. Dicot leaf, dorsiventral leaf. Monocot leaf, isobilateral leaf. What is the meaning of dorsiventral leaf? Mesophyll is differentiated into pollicyte and spongy parenchyma. It's called dorsiventral leaf. What is isobilateral leaf? Mesophyll is not differentiated into pollicyte and spongy parenchyma is called isobilateral leaf. Next, plastids. Plastids are double membrane bound organelles found in plant and some algae. Usually, all the cell organelles are bound in a membrane. But plastids, double membrane bound organelles. What is the functions of plastids? The plastids function is preparation and storage of food. There are three types of plastids: chloroplast, chromoplast, and leucoplast. Chloroplast is green colored plastids, chromoplast yellow, red, and orange color plastids, leucoplast is colorless plastids. Next, structure of chloroplasts. It is a very very important 5 mark question, also diagram questions. First, envelope, stroma. This is the envelope. Next, stroma, thylakoids. This is the thylakoids and granum. Each coins is called thylakoids, then all together is called granum. So first one, envelope. There are two envelopes are covered in the chloroplast. One is outer membrane and inner membrane, so which is separated by that intermembrane space. This is the intermembrane space, outer membrane, inner membrane, so in between separated by the intermembrane space. Next, stroma. Stroma matrix present inside the membrane is called stroma. All the spacious, it contains DNA, 70S ribosomes, and other molecules required for protein synthesis. Next, thylakoids. So here the coins like structure is called thylakoids. It consists of thylakoid membrane that encloses thylakoid lumen. Thylakoids forms the stack of disc like structure is called granum. So all together granum, grana. Next, some of the thylakoids are arranged in the form of disc stacked one above the other. So one above another, the coins like a structure is present. It is all together we will call the granum. They are interconnected to each other by membranous lamellae is called Fret channels. This is a Fret channels. Functions of chloroplast: photosynthesis, storage of starch and lipids, then synthesis of fatty acids, then formation of chloroplast. These are the main functions of chloroplast.